This is the schematic of a PSV system. Here you find the key cabinet, the PSVs, and the interlocked inlet and outlet valves. This icon depicts an interlock valve. This valve is locked closed, since it is colored black. The right square indicates the open key, the left square the closed key. When the square line is thin, the key is not inserted. A thick line shows a trapped key. The same goes for the key cabinet. This key is entered in the cabinet. These keys can be entered back into the cabinet after valve operation. In real life, all four keys are actually entered into one similar key position. The drawing of four separate positions is for schematic purposes only. The star key of this sequence, key A, is taken from the key cabinet. There are two different key paths that key A can travel. The first route is to the outlet valve of PSV B, which is currently open. As shown, key E is currently trapped in the lock on V1. V1 cannot yet be operated since key A is not yet inserted. When key A is inserted, V1 is closed. Key A is now trapped in the lock on V1 and key E is released. By removing key E from V1, this valve is now locked for operation. Key E is now taken back into the key cabinet. By this operation, PSVB has been completely isolated and can be taken out for maintenance. Key A can also be inserted in the lock on V2. In this lock, key B is currently trapped. When key A is inserted, V2 is opened. Key A is now trapped in the lock on V2 and key B is released. Key B is now taken to V3, which is currently opened and has key C trapped inside. Key B is inserted in V3, V3 is closed and key C is released. After key C is removed, V3 is locked for operation. PSV B is now operational and PSV A is in spare.